Hello friends, now let us see the joint venture accounting procedure. Friends, in this lesson, we will discuss the concept of joint venture business. We will also discuss the difference between the joint venture and partnership and also the difference between the joint venture and a consignment. The features and benefits of joint venture will also be discussed. It is essential to know the methods of keeping accounts in case of joint venture business. The illustration of these methods are also discussed. All these things are covered one by one starting from the introduction of the topic of joint venture. Number one, introduction. Joint venture is a form of business organization. It is a partnership, but without the use of the name. Joint venture can be called as a temporary partnership, as it is formed for a specific purpose by two or more persons, and after the fulfillment of the purpose for which it was formed, the joint venture automatically comes to an end. For example, A and B may come together and form a joint venture for consigning the goods to C. After the transaction is complete, the joint venture between A and B will be dissolved. Similarly, persons may come together for trading goods, construction of building or other infrastructure, underwriting of shares or any other purpose. The profits and losses arising out of such business are shared by the persons who come together for this business. Persons who thus come together are called as co-venturers. The co-venturers invest capital in the business, and after the purpose of business is achieved, the partnership comes to an end. Point number second, features of joint venture. Number one, two or more persons come together and enter into an agreement to run the business. Number two, no specific name is necessary for the firm formed for a joint venture business. Number three, the objective of forming the business is limited to that specific business. Number four, the persons forming the joint venture are known as co-venturers. The co-venturers agree to share profits or losses arising from the particular business in the agreed proportion. The profits or losses will be shared equally in the absence of any agreement about the proportion. Number five, the joint venture comes to an end as soon as the venture, that is the business for which it is formed, comes to an end. Number six, the venturers are free to do any other business of their own during the course of the venture. Number three, benefits of joint venture. Number one, in joint venture, as there is more than one person, the business risk is shared by these persons. Thus, there is no burden on a single person, as the profits or losses are shared by the co-venturers in the agreed ratio. Number two, the capacity of raising the necessary capital is always limited in case of a sole proprietor. However, in case of joint venture, as more than one person come together, the ability to raise financial resources is increased. In joint venture, as more co-venturers come together, they can share their experience. The combined experience of all the co-venturers is beneficial to the business. Now we will see in the point number 4, difference between partnership and a joint venture. Number 1, the joint venture is established for a limited objective, and after the fulfillment of that objective, the joint venture business comes to an end. On the other hand, partnership business has a continuing nature and is not limited to a particular purpose only. Number 2, the persons carrying on the partnership are called as partners, while the persons carrying on the business of a joint venture are called as co-venturers. Number 3, a partnership business has a firm's name, while no such name exists in the case of joint venture business. Number 4, co-venturers in a joint venture have freedom to run their own business independently, including a competing business. However, in partnership, no such freedom exists for partners. Number 6, a minor can be admitted to the benefits of partnership, while in case of joint venture, no such minor person can be admitted. Next point that we will discuss, difference between joint venture and consignment. A consignment of goods means the sending of the goods by a manufacturer or wholesaler to his agent for the purpose of selling them on behalf of the wholesaler or manufacturer. The person who sends the goods is known as consignor, while the person to whom the goods are sent is known as the consignee. The goods are sold by the consignee on behalf of the consignor, and a consignee gets a commission for that. On the other hand, in joint venture, two or more persons come together and carry on a business activity to fulfill a particular purpose. After the purpose is fulfilled, the joint venture comes to an end. The profits or losses arising out of the business are shared by the persons who form the joint venture. These persons are called as co-venturers. The main points of difference between the joint venture and consignment, now we will discuss. Number 1, in consignment, the consignee who is an agent of the consignor gets commission for selling the goods on behalf of the consignor. On the other hand, in case of joint venture, the co-venturers get their share of profits arising out of the business. Number 2, in consignment, the parties are known as consignor and consignee, while in case of joint venture, the persons coming together are called as the co-venturers. Number 3, the relationship between the consignor and consignee is that of a principal and an agent. In case of joint venture, the co-venturers are partners. Number 4, joint venture is established for limited purpose. For example, it may be established for a particular activity like construction of a building. The joint venture business is closed as soon as the activity is completed. Thus, relationship between co-venturers is limited and comes to an end after the completion of the business. In consignment, the relationship between the consignor and consignee may continue in future also. Number 5, in consignment, the consignee is an agent of the consignor and does not invest any capital in the business. On the other hand, the co-venturers invest capital in their business. Number 6, the consignor is the only owner in case of consignment. However, in case of joint venture, all co-venturers are the owners. Number 7, consignment is usually limited for sale of goods. However, a joint venture business may be to carry on any activity such as purchase and sale of goods, underwriting of shares, construction of building, etc. Number 8, the consignee gets commission for the services rendered by him. In case of joint venture, the co-venturers share the profits or losses arising in case of joint venture business. Number 9, there is only one method of recording the consignment transactions. On the other hand, there are various methods of recording of joint venture business activities. Point number 6, accounting treatment. The basic objective of the accounting procedures in case of joint venture business is to find out profits or losses arising out of the business. Accounting treatment, in that, number 1, separate set of books maintained. Number 2 is no separate books maintained. And number 3 is memorandum joint venture account. The 3 methods now we will discuss. Number 1, when separate books are maintained. In this method, these procedures is followed. Number 1, A joint venture account is open in the books of the firm and it is prepared on the basis of profit and loss account. This account shows profit or loss. Number 2, a joint bank account is open for recording the cash or the bank transactions. In this account, the initial contributions made by co-venturers is deposited in this account along with the amount received on account of sales. The expenses are incurred from this account and the net balance in this account is distributed among co-venturers on the completion of the joint venture business. Number 3, in addition to the joint venture account and joint bank account, accounts of co-venturers is also maintained. Now we will see the journal entries in this method. Number 1, transaction is initial contribution of the co-venturers. Journal entry for this is joint bank account debited to co-venturers account and the narration given is the being the amount contributed by the co-venturers deposited in the joint bank account. Serial number, number 2, goods sent by co-venturers out of his own stock. Journal entry for this, joint venture account debit to co-venturers account and the narration will be being the goods supplied by co-venturers from their own stock. Number 3, expenses paid by co-venturers. Joint venture account debited to co-venturers account is the journal entry. Narration for that being expenses paid by customers. Going to number 4, material purchased out of joint venture funds. Journal entry is joint venture account debit to joint bank account and the narration is being the material purchased out of joint venture funds. Entry number 5, expenses paid out of joint bank account. Joint venture account debited to joint bank account and the narration is being the expenses paid out of joint bank account. Number 6, for goods sold for cash. Entry will be joint bank account debited to joint venture account. Number 7, contract / sale price received either in the form of cash or shares. Entry will be joint bank account / shares account debit to joint venture account and the narration will be being the contract price received either in cash or in shares. Number 8, commission / salary to co-venturers, joint venture account debited to co-venturers account. Number 9, unsold goods taken over by co-venturers, co-venturers account debited to joint venture account and the narration is being the unsold goods taken over by the co-venturers. Number 10, shares taken over by co-venturers. Entry will be co-venturers account debit to shares account and the narration will be being the shares taken over by co-venturers. Number 11, if shares are sold in open, joint bank account will be debited and shares account will be credited and the narration will be being the shares sold in open market. Number 12, for profits on joint venture. So, joint venture account debit to co-venturers account. Narration being the profit on joint venture shared by the co-venturers. There is a note, if there is a loss, the entry will be opposite of this entry. And 13, transaction number 13 for final distribution of funds. It will be co-venturer's account debited to joint bank account, and the narration will be being the final payment to the co-venturers. So, friends, these are the journal entries which are passed in the books. Now, friends, we will see the illustration. Aditya and Amit entered into a joint venture to buy and sell goods for festival purpose. They opened a joint bank account. Aditya deposited rupees 2 lakhs and Amit rupees 1,50,000 in the joint bank account. Aditya supplied goods worth rupees 25,000 and Amit supplied decoration material worth rupees 15,000. These payments were made by the venture in that A, cost of goods purchased rupees 2,50,000, B, transportation charges rupees 12,000, C, advertising rupees 7,500 and sundry expenses rupees 2,500. They sold the goods for rupees 4 lakhs for cash. Aditya took over some goods for rupees 30,000 and Amit took remaining goods worth rupees 10,000. The profits or losses were to be shared equally between the co-venturers. Prepare joint venture account, joint bank account and each co-venturer's account. So, friends, we have to open all the three accounts. So, starting from joint venture account, let us see entries coming on the debit side. First entry on the debit side is to Aditya's account for material 25,000. This is the material supplied by Aditya individually to the joint venture. Again, to Amit's account for materials which is supplied by Amit, amount of the entry is 15,000. Next is to joint bank account for materials. Amount is 2,50,000 rupees. This is the material purchased out of joint venture. To joint bank account for transportation expense, 12,000. To joint bank account for advertising, 7,500. And to joint bank account for sundry expenses, 2,500 rupees. All these expenses are paid jointly, and hence joint venture account debit and joint bank account is credited in each of this transaction. Before we calculate the profit on the debit side, if you see the credit side, it will be by joint bank account sales, amount of the entry is equal to 4 lakh. These are the goods which are sold on account of joint venture, so they are credited. Aditya has taken over certain goods. Entry passed is by Aditya's account for goods taken over and the amount of the entry is 30,000 and by Amit's account even for the goods taken over and the amount is rupees 10,000. So, Aditya and Amit, both of them have taken over some goods and the entries are passed on the credit side by debiting their respective personal accounts. For closing joint venture, we take the difference between the credit side total and the debit side total, and as the credit side is more than the debit side, it represents a profit. Total profit on the joint venture is 1,28,000 rupees divided equally between Aditya and Amit as given in the example, and the entry that is passed is 2 profit on joint venture. For Aditya it will be 64,000, for Amit also it is 64,000. Total amount of profit is 1,28,000 and the total of the joint venture account is 4,40,000 rupees. With this, joint venture account will be closed in this case. If you go to joint bank account, that is the next account that we are preparing, again divided between the debit and the credit side. If you check up entries on the debit side, it will be to Aditya's account rupees 2 lakhs, to Amit's account 1,50,000. These are the two entries which are passed for initial contribution made by Aditya and Amit towards the joint venture. While Aditya has contributed 2 lakhs, Amit has contributed 1,50,000. So, the amounts are debited to joint bank account and credited to the personal account of the co-venturers. Next entry which comes on the debit side is to joint venture account for the sale of goods. Amount of sale received deposited in the joint bank account and the amount of the transaction is rupees 4 lakhs. If you go to the credit side, on credit side, you will find that by joint venture account, this is for purchase of material and the amount that we have taken is 2,50,000 rupees. Similarly, again by joint venture for transportation expenses paid 12,000 rupees, by joint venture account for advertising 7,500 rupees, by joint venture account for sundry expenses 2,500 rupees. And if you see the last two entries are for final settlement. By Aditya's account, amount of the entry is 2,59,000. By Amit's account, the entry is 2,19,000. Now, how these two amounts have come? You will find it in the personal account that we have opened of Aditya's account and Amit's account. And this is the balance which is paid to them, and that is why it is called as final settlement. And in the joint bank account, the total that we have taken on the both the sides is 7,50,000 rupees. So, with this, joint bank account is completed. Now, going to each co-venturer's account. This is Aditya's account. If you see the debit side, it is to joint venture account and it is representing material purchased 30,000 rupees. Now, before we see the entry on the debit side, let us see entries coming on the credit side. There are three entries coming on the credit side. One is by joint bank account, which is for initial deposits 2 lakh rupees, by joint venture account, that is for materials, which is 25,000 rupees, and again by joint venture account for profits, that is 64,000 rupees. Now, if you see the difference between credit side and debit side, that is the balance payable to Aditya, and this balance payable to Aditya is shown on the debit side through joint bank account. So, if you see the entry number 2 coming on the debit side, it is to joint bank account for final settlement and the amount of the transaction is 2,59,000, and then the total of this account comes to 2,89,000 rupees on both the sides. With this, Aditya's account you will find is closed. And then going to the final account in this example, and that is the Amit's account. See the entry on the debit side. To joint venture account, material that is taken over by him, amount 10,000 rupees. Now go to credit side before we come back to the final entry on the debit side. On credit side, it is by joint bank account, that is 1,50,000, that is initial deposits. By joint venture account for material which is supplied by Amit, amount of the entry is 15,000, and again by joint venture account, the share of the profit of Amit, which is 64,000 rupees. And then take the total of the credit side, take the total of debit side, which is 10,000 only, and finding out the difference. The difference is 2,19,000, which is payable to Amit. And the entry is shown on the debit side, you will find the entry is passed as to joint bank account, and this represents final settlement of the account. And if you see the entry, the amount of the entry is 2,19,000. Total in the Amit's account on both sides, 2,29,000 rupees, and Amit's accounts are closed. So, friends, let us conclude today's session. We have seen one method of the keeping accounts in joint venture business. The second And the third method will be covered in the next lesson. Thank you very much and all the best.